Welcome to this video tutorial, one of many in a series designed to get you up and running with Leapfrog. This video is part 2 of 4 discussing drill hole data in Leapfrog. In this video, I'm going to cover drill hole data validation and error fixing. In part 1, I left off with a project into which I had imported a set of drill holes. You'll notice that each of the drill hole tables has a little red X on the table symbol. When drill holes are imported into Leapfrog, a number of common drill hole errors are identified and flagged in the project. There are 4 classes of errors which you can fix in Leapfrog. The first way to use Leapfrog to find errors is to visually check the drill holes. This can often show really obvious errors. These errors may include collars that have had values transposed, or a decimal point placed in the wrong location, resulting in the drill hole being outside of its expected location. By importing and visualizing the data, you can easily find and replace such database errors. Secondly, tables marked with a red X contain errors that mean data cannot be used for processing. These errors can be corrected by right-clicking on the table and selecting Fix Errors. Third, numeric data columns marked with little red X could contain 2 different types of errors. The first is a non-numeric value, such as a less than sign to indicate below detection limit. Also, Leapfrog flags any non-positive numeric values as well, such as a negative number or a 0. Lastly, tables marked with an orange exclamation point contains warnings. Warnings may include collars with no values or duplicated drill holes. In this case, we don't see any exclamation points, but we will later on as we work with the data. If there are any errors in the drill hole database, the row that the error is in will be excluded from any models which are created using that data. It is a good idea to fix all the errors as soon as possible to make sure the models contain all available data. An exclamation point, however, indicating a warning, does not result in the exclusion of any data. There are 2 options for fixing errors and warnings in Leapfrog. For option 1, information about the errors can be exported from Leapfrog into a CSV, and this allows the user to fix the errors in the original database. If possible, we highly recommend this option so that errors do not persist in your database and propagate to other projects. You can either export the errors from all the drill holes at the same time, or the errors from only one drill hole table. To export the errors from all the drill hole tables, right-click on the top level drill holes object in the project tree and select Export Errors. To export from a single table, simply right-click that table and again select Export Errors. This will export a single CSV file containing the errors for that table. Once fixed in the database, the drill holes can then be reloaded into Leapfrog by simply right-clicking Drill Holes, Reload. This will be covered in part 4 of the drill hole data video tutorial series. If it is not possible to fix the errors in the original data, then the errors can be fixed within Leapfrog. There are a number of different error types that Leapfrog flags. I'll go through each table in this project and discuss the errors we find. To look at the errors, right-click Fix Errors. In this case, we'll start by clicking the little black triangle until we can see the row that contains the error. Here we see that row 18 and 19 actually contain duplicate information. To deal with this error, we simply need to ignore one of these rows and click OK. Once we have fixed that error, we've noticed the X has gone away for our collar table and has been replaced by that exclamation point denoting a warning. Next, I'm going to fix errors for the survey table. In this table, we see one of the holes has exceeded the collar max depth. In this case, I have a survey reading that is deeper than the max depth we had for this hole in the collar file. This can sometimes happen when the collar file still contains the planned depth, but the survey file and the interval tables contain the actual drilled depth. This error is easy to deal with, as all we need to do is click the Fix Collar Max Depths button once, and it will fix that error throughout that table. Next, we're going to deal with the geology table. Right-click Fix Errors And we can see what Leapfrog has identified here. By expanding the little black triangle, I can see that row 123 has an issue where the from depth is greater than the to depth. And we can see that this was just reversed. We can fix it within Leapfrog by simply clicking into the cell and typing in the correct values. You will notice that the values we have entered are bold, and this allows us to see what we have manually edited within Leapfrog. The next error that Leapfrog's identified is overlapping segments. If we look at the two rows that Leapfrog has identified in this case, we can see actually that row 23 is going to conflict with row 19, 20, 21, and 22, given that this interval goes from 46 all the way to 480. In this case, if I simply ignore row 23, it should take care of all of these overlapping segment errors as well. Lastly, I'll right-click on the contamination folder and select Fix Errors. In this case, we can see that there are no errors contained in the table itself. This indicates that there is nothing wrong with our from, to, or whole ID columns, but we can see that there is an error in the contamination column, as represented by this little X. So I will close this and open the contamination column itself. To do so, I can simply double-click and it opens the invalid value handling window. There are three possible types of errors here: missing values, non-numeric values, and non-positive numeric values. In this case, I can see that I have 30 missing intervals. The default action is to simply omit those intervals. However, depending on the reason they are missing, I could also select to replace them with another value. In this case, I leave the action as omit. I can see that I have no non-numeric values in this data set, but I do have two non-positive values. To see the non-positive values, simply click Add Rule and it will show them to you. I can select which action I wish to do to these values. As soon as I click to add this rule, this default action no longer applies. When it comes to non-positive values, I have the option to omit, replace, or keep. In this case, I'm going to keep those zeros as zeros. Once I have reviewed all of my invalid values, I can tick "These rules have been reviewed," click OK, and the X will be removed from that table. Now that we've dealt with all the errors, let's talk a little bit more about the warnings. We can see there are still little orange exclamation points for a few of the tables, indicating there are warnings, but not errors. We can view the warnings the same way we view the errors, by right-clicking Fix Error. In this case, we can see there is no value for whole ID MAR024A. Let's take a look at the warnings from some of the other tables as well. In this case, we can see there's actually no records for that hole either in the geology table or in the weathering table. In the contamination table, we can see there's actually quite a few holes that don't have values, including MAR024A. If we would like to get rid of these warning exclamation points, we can actually ignore that hole from the table by double-clicking the caller table, searching for that hole, and clicking Ignore. Now we can see the only warnings left are the missing values in the contamination table.